Hey, what's up, guys? This is Anthony from Anthony's Customs, and for this review, we are looking at the Marvel Legends Blackheart figure. This is a figure that I think doesn't get enough credit. I think most people just kind of write it off as not being that great. You never hear anybody talking about it or posing it or anything like that, but it's a very decent figure. There are a couple of things that I don't really care for about it, but by and large, it's pretty darn good. The only way they could make it better, I think, is if they gave him that bulkier look like the custom I made and just about everybody else has made using the Venom body. It looks much better, I think. But still, this is not bad. It's completely unique sculpt to my knowledge. I don't think any other figure uses any of this. And it's a decent size, too. His legs are a little bit bent right now due to the feet being the way they are. But he's almost 9 inches tall right now, and then he has the tail, and that is the real big issue I have with it. It's way too stiff to pose, and then you end up, a lot of people I've heard have just ripped it off trying to pose it. It's way too stiff. Maybe if you heat it up first, you can get it to hold a pose, but the wire is not stronger than the metal, or the wire isn't stronger. The wire isn't stronger than the plastic, so it doesn't hold a pose that well, and it sticks straight out. So you're going to have a little trouble posing that effectively. But that aside, it's pretty good. There's, like I said, tons of sculpt work on this guy, so that makes him look good automatically. And then he's got some pretty cool shading. We have some blues and purples going on everywhere. The eyes are painted red. The little hair tendril things are almost all individually sculpted. We have some clusters here and there, but for the most part, it's pretty good. I like it a lot. And the head articulation is really good. Looks up and down because we have that hinge side to side. You can lean it a little bit. But then, of course, we have the rotation. The shoulders give you pretty good range of motion for being studded like that. So that's pretty good. Bicep swivel is fine. Double jointed elbow. A wrist swivel. A wrist hinge. And a finger hinge. The ab crunch works really well. And this, well, not really well. It works pretty well forward. Not so well going back, and then the paint is kind of not so great there, but I think that's probably okay. I like the anatomy for this guy, other than being a little thin, more thin than I would prefer. It's still really well sculpted. We have a waist twist in here. Not sure why it's ratcheted, but it is. We have T-jointed hips, so you can get pretty good range of motion out of those. Thigh swivel built in. Mine's a little loose, but I've had others that weren't, so I wouldn't worry about that too much. Double jointed knee, a shin swivel, an ankle hinge, an ankle rocker, and then a toe hinge. So he's just got a really decent setup. His articulation's good, his sculpt is good. I think this is one of the better Marvel Legends figures. If that tail was better, there wouldn't be much to complain about at all. I think this guy is a really, really good figure. So if you're thinking about picking one up, do it. Definitely pick it up, especially before he ends up in a movie or something and then he gets really valuable. Unless I've missed something, I don't think he's highly sought after right now, but I think he should be. He's a really good figure. I kind of forgot how much I like this guy. So maybe if they make a new one, maybe they could make him a little bit thicker, but it's definitely not necessary. He's still really cool looking. So I definitely 100% recommend this figure. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you subscribe to the channel so you can see my upcoming figure reviews, custom figures, and other good stuff. And in the meantime, keep collecting.